In this video, we are discussing the vertical circular motion from a non-inertial frame of reference. So, this is similar to the case which we have already discussed, that if some external constant force is being applied on the vertical circular motion, then what will be the minimum projection velocity? So this would be the similar case, but the only difference is the fact that we are standing inside a non-inertial frame, or we are standing inside an accelerated frame. So there is a cart, as you can see, which is accelerating with an acceleration of 3g upon 4, and there is a vertical circular motion going inside the cart, and we have to find out the minimum velocity and the maximum tension. In fact, we have to find out the maximum tension in this string in the first question. So first of all, we know that for the motion, the ball will be having a equilibrium position in this direction, because the pseudo force is also acting in the ball in the reverse direction, which is 3mg upon 4. This is the pseudo force, F pseudo, because we are standing in a non-inertial frame of reference, and a force mg will be acting in the downward direction. So if this angle is theta, which is already given to us, then this is also theta. So tan theta will be equal to mg upon 3mg upon 4. So theta will be equal to 53 degree. You can see that the tan theta is equal to 4 upon 3. So this position will be the position of equilibrium, and we have to find out the maximum tension in the case when the ball is being already projected. So don't confuse it with the tension which we have calculated in the earlier video, because that tension was the tension when the ball was in equilibrium. But in this case, we have to find out the maximum tension in the case when we have already projected the ball. Now, first of all, the V minimum will be equal to under root of 5G effective into L. And the G effective will be equal to under root of 9 by 16 mg square plus mg square, which is equal to 5 by 4 mg. This is G effective. Now V minimum is equal to under root of G effective will not have M, so it is 5 by 4 G. So V minimum will be equal to under root of 25 GL by 4, because it is we are putting the value in this equation. So it will be V minimum will be equal to 5 by 2 root GL. Now the tension in the rope, maximum tension, will be in this position, and we have to find out the maximum tension in the case when the ball is already being projected. This is very important to note, that ball is already being projected and it is moving, just started to move with a velocity of 5 by 2 root GL from the lowest, from this point, and then we have to find out the tension. So this tension T maximum will be equal to, I'm writing it down here, M V square upon L, as well as the resultant force of this. So the resultant force will be 5 by 4 mg, the resultant of this pseudo force and this mg. The value of V is already 25, in fact 5 by 2 root GL. So T maximum will be equal to 25 by 4 mg plus 5 by 4 mg, which is equal to 15 by 2 mg. So the correct option will be option number C. Now we move on the next question associated with this one. This is a comprehension. So in this question, we have to find out the minimum possible speed during the whole path when the body completes the circular motion. So we know already that the minimum possible speed is in just opposite direction of the equilibrium position. So the equilibrium position is this one, this is A, and the minimum possible speed will be at this one, point C. So the VC, we all know, is under root of 5. In fact, VC is under root of G effective into L, and G effective, as we have already calculated, is 5 by 4 G. So VC will be equal to root of 5 by 4 GL. So this will be the C will be the correct answer. Now the next question, which is also associated with the comprehension, that for what value of angle theta the tension in the rope will be minimum. We know that the tension of the rope is minimum also at position C, which is the topmost position, but the top position, which we say the top, is the position in which is directly opposite the equilibrium position. So the equilibrium position in this question is point A, and therefore at position C the tension will be minimum tension, and that tension will be minimum zero. Now this angle theta, we have already calculated that this angle is 53 degrees. So the correct answer will be option number B.